Blog Talk Radio.
Testing, testing, I'm just suggesting you and I might not be the best thing. Exit, exit, somehow I guessed it right. Alright, but I still want ya, don't mean to taunt ya. If you leave now, I'll come back and haunt ya. You'll remember, return to sender now.
I'm Amanda.
And I'm Max.
And on today's show, we have Josh Ramsay of Marianas Trench.
Hey, how did you pronounce it?
Sorry. Oh, hello, Josh.
Did you just say Marianas Trench? That's awesome.
Marianas Trench. Yeah.
And Marianas Trench.
Sorry.
Oh, it's all good. It's all good. You know what? I was, I've heard the song before, so I kind of had you, I'm not going to lie. I had you on speakerphone and I've just been eating strawberries.
And you
didn't
share
eating
because?
Them.
Why didn't you
because
share?
Because they're delicious and I wish I could share these with you guys because they're really good.
Well, you know, you could try shoving them through the phone. They might get to us.
Yeah, I think it'll wreck the phone though.
Yeah.
All right.
What am I going to do that?
I guess I will ask the first question. You are on a U.S. tour with Simple Plan right now, right?
Incorrect. No, actually, yes. That is correct. I'm not going to give you guys serious answers. I'm warning you now.
How has the tour been going so far for you?
For me, like, emotionally, is that what you want to know? Or, like, spiritually?
Both.
17.
Okay.
Is that not a suitable answer? Good.
Sure.
Good. It's a good tour. It's a good tour. You know, there's us and some other bands. And everybody's really nice, and it's good. Simple Plan keep crashing our tour bus, though. I don't mean crashing it into stuff, like accident. I mean, like, end of the night, you know, you get a bunch of drunken French Canadians come barging onto your bus. It's more like that.
So, note for bands that tour with Simple Plan, lock your bus door.
Lock the doors and never give them the code to enter the door. Never give them that code, because they'll abuse it.
All right. So, who are your biggest musical influences?
My biggest musical influences? Edward Scissorhands. I mean, the guy just couldn't get a break, you know? All I wanted to do was make some awesome, awesome hedge creatures and bush creatures and, you know, give a few unsuspecting townsfolk, you know, some nice haircuts and maybe in the process learn a little something about this crazy thing we call human spirit. And the guy just couldn't get a damn break, you know? And it sucks for that guy.
Yeah, pretty does.
Okay. If you were stuck in a music video for the rest of your life, what music video would you choose?
Oh, my God, that's a terrifying question. Stuck in a music video for the rest of my life? Dude. Mm-hmm. I don't know, man. I can't think of any music video that you would want to be stuck in forever. I mean, they would all become a nightmare if it turned into, like, an infinite amount of time. I don't know. What's yours? What's yours there, Hotshot?
I'm not really sure, actually.
Not as easy to answer as you thought.
If I had to choose a Marianas Trench one, I really loved Celebrity Status, so...
No, you don't want to be stuck in that video. Trust me, I was stuck in that video for the entire time that we shot it, and you don't want to be in there. It's a dark and dangerous place.
Oh, well, maybe I could choose
TV blew up in
because I'd be the girl.
A TV actually blew up in my face when we shot that video. It did.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, it wasn't the most awesome thing that's ever happened.
But you're alive.
And unharmed.
Yes.
Well, I do my best.
Okay, we have a Twitter question from Primetime MTSR. They want to know if any of the songs on Ever After have a personal meaning for you, like Lover Dearest.
Well, every song is personal to me. They always are. I don't write songs about made-up things, so they're always about something. So, they're all personal. Unless you're inventing things, but it's not really what I do.
So what song would you choose to talk about?
Sorry?
So what song would you choose to talk about right now?
Oh, I don't know. You know what? I usually don't like to give away too much of what any song is actually specifically about for me, because I don't think it really matters what it's about to me, because, you know, it's more it's more like anybody who listens to a song, it's going to mean whatever it is to that person because of you know, the way that person interprets it. So I don't really like to give away too much because maybe what it means to me is not something that it means to someone else, and maybe that'll wreck what it means to them, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
true. All right, we'll go ahead and take a caller.
Okay.
483.
Caller, you are on the air.
Hi. So, what's one thing that you would absolutely never do?
What's one thing I would never do?
Like, never, ever.
Like, never, ever.
Ever. Like,
are you talking like...
Anything.
Hold on, you gotta say that again. What?
Okay, if it's one thing that you would never do, like ever in your life, you wouldn't consider doing it.
I think if I killed somebody, I probably would not eat the body to hide the evidence. There's a lot to get through.
That's a good answer.
It's a lot to get through.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Thank you for calling.
No problem. I'm glad these hard-hitting questions are finally getting answered. Too long have I hid behind the shroud of not answering such questions.
Yeah. Why not just not kill the person instead of killing them and then not eating the body?
All right. Okay. How is Ever After different from Masterpiece Theater?
Well, it is different songs, so there's that. I don't know. I like it better for me. I think it flows better. I think it's a more cohesive, collection of songs. Like, I think stylistically it's still sort of all over the map, like the last one was. But I think even though it is still sort of all over the place, I think it still kind of comes together and flows from one thing to the other in a better way. And I feel like the writing on this record is a little more mature than what was written on the previous record. And I also just think, like, I don't think I was ready when we did Masterpiece Theater. I already had the idea of, like, hey, let's write a, like, I want to do a record where everything is just one song and everything flows together, but I don't think I was really ready for that yet. So I had to wait till this time. But I think this is the better album.
I agree. It's the only album that I own in my entire collection of 200 CDs that I cannot put on shuffle.
It wouldn't work on shuffle, right? It would throw off the whole vibe.
So
yeah, it would throw off the whole vibe.
I don't even start in the middle. I always go one to end every single time I listen to it.
See, and that's what I was hoping for. Because if you don't, then you're not. It's kind of like putting it on shuffle inside of a song, right? Like, and hearing the bridge first.
Yeah.
You wouldn't do that, you know?
Right.
All right. So, if you wasn't in a band, what would you be doing?
Are you talking to me? Because I can't understand a word you're saying.
Yes. If you wasn't in a band, what would you be doing?
If I wasn't in a band, what would I be doing? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably be that hilariously charming homeless guy that lives down the street who, you know, has like witty little one-liners and stuff and while people walk by and probably makes a decent living, you know, eats a lot of apples and almonds.
That's the most interesting answer we've had.
Well, I mean, let's be honest, what else can I possibly do? I'm not good at anything. So it's either music or homeless. So that's what they told me on career day.
And this is why you're my favorite. Okay. Oh, yeah, it's my turn. Ugh. Okay.
This is online,
it,
right? Sorry, can I ask a question?
Yeah.
This is online. So, okay, am I allowed to swear and stuff?
Go for it. I mean, nobody listens to Don't Say Fuck anyway, so.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure before I do anything bad. Okay, go for it. What was your question? Sorry.
What was it like performing Fallout for the first time in Chicago?
Sticky, mostly. Whoa, what is that beeping noise? I don't know. I'm always nervous when it's the first time we do a song. Fallout, I wasn't crazy nervous about, because we had sort of practiced it on the bus that day. I think the more nervous one was the first time we did Haven't Had Enough and another song on the record called By Now. The first time we did that was at, like, we had never played them live before, and we did those two songs when no one had ever even heard them because, like, the album hadn't come out, single hadn't even come out. We did them live at a summer festival for, like, 12,000 people, and we had never played them live before, and that made me a little more nervous.
Well, to help you feel better, I think you did an amazing job because I was there.
Oh, thanks.
So great job, and we're going to take a caller.
Caller, you are on the air.
7382, you're on the air.
Me?
Yes, you.
Oh my God. Oh, okay. I didn't even think I'd, like, make it. Okay, this is awesome.
Well, you did.
Oh, goodness. Hello. Hi, Josh.
Hey.
I love Ever After. It's been on repeat since I downloaded it the first day, and I've listened to absolutely nothing else since it, and that is the truth.
Thanks, dude.
Dirty pirate.
My question would probably have to be, what is your favorite part about America? Like, what do you like about touring America?
Right now, what I like about touring America is it's a chance to win over a whole new country of people, you know, and it's like, it's kind of fun starting over. You know, we got to a certain level in Canada, and then we had, then, you know, we came south, and it was time to start over again, and it literally has already gone from, you know, the first couple shows, like, it was like we're already, you know, multi-platinum in our own country, and then we're coming to the States and playing for, like, three people, and it's already gone from that to like, you know, 1,500 people, and that's pretty good I feel pretty good about it because I feel like it's going faster here than it took us in Canada the first time around, and I think it's a little easier the second time because you're a little more confident because you know you've done it once before. But it, honestly, like, what I really like about touring here is getting to feel that, like, that hungry climb up again.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for calling.
Pretty cool.
And real fast, could you give a shout out to my friend Shayla?
Hey. Shayla.
Okay. Now, what's the craziest thing a fan has ever done for you?
For me or to me?
To you.
There's been a lot, man. Avoiding, like, the serious ones where there's, like, stalkers, things like that, avoiding that ridiculous stuff. I don't know. There's been a bunch of weird stuff, man. Like, you know, most people are cool and usually really respectful to us and stuff and really rad. But every now and then you get that weird shit. Like, we did a New Year's show, maybe a year ago or 2 years ago now. I can't remember. And I was up standing on the barriers while I was singing and I thought I got stabbed in the stomach and I looked down and I was like, fucking, like, a full mouth, like, teeth impression in my stomach. And some girl lifted up my shirt and just, like, bit the shit out of me. And I actually still have a little scar on my stomach. That was weird. Mostly just because, like, regardless of your reasons for biting me, it just still doesn't add up. Either you hate me, but in which case, why are you at the front row at my concert, like, just to bite me in the stomach? Like, that's a lot of effort to go through just to bite someone. Or the B side of that is that you like our stuff, which is also weird because I don't understand the feeling of, like, I love this band so much, I'm going to bite the shit out of this guy. You know what I mean? Like, that's just weird. It's just weird. There was also a girl that made a voodoo doll. Well, it wasn't supposed to be a voodoo doll, but I interpreted it like that. This girl made a doll of me, and she cut off her own hair and dyed it and used the hair as my hair, and she gave it to me, and it looked shockingly like a voodoo doll. And I really didn't know how to respond because I was terrified. You're kind of like, oh, good. That's a, something a crazy person gives somebody.
Yeah.
I'm glad it's not the part where I ran.
Oh, my God, it was you. It was you. It was totally you. That awkward pause at the end of that story. Your silence gives away everything. All right, stay away from me.
No, it wasn't me. I was the one that almost got ran across, that ran across the street and almost got hit by a freaking car. That was me.
Oh, jeez. Jeez, that sucks.
I was dared to do that, by the way. They were like, just go over there. I was like, fine, I will. And I just ran across the street. I was like, oh, shit, there's cars.
Yeah, that's what happens in places where vehicles travel.
Yes, I felt like a dumbass. And then it's your turn.
We have a Twitter question. This is from Sydney. She wants to know if you have any legit advice for someone who truly wants to make it in the industry.
Learn how to write songs. You know, honestly, like, I know that sounds so simple and like, oh, what a lame answer, but really, like, learn how to write songs. And don't be a snob about, like, what kind of genre you want to write. Just learn how to write good songs and how to recognize a good song when you hear it, regardless of if it's a country song or a pop song or a rock song or a metal song or whatever. You know, learn how to just pick out good songs rather than good genres, because there is no such thing as a good or bad genre. There's only, you know, good writers, bad writers.
Mm-hmm. And is there anything
And hopefully
that...
be one of the good writers. Sorry, what?
Yeah, it's okay. Is there anything that you dislike about the music industry?
That I dislike?
Yeah.
Yeah, 90% of it. Or all of it, the actual industry? Yeah. No, I hate the music industry. It's terrible. I don't, honestly, like, I know it sounds ridiculous considering how I make my living, but, like, you know, if you really think about it, you can't do, you know, it's impossible to do anything artistic, like art for art's sake, if you're selling it. You know what I mean? Like, as soon as something becomes commerce, then it's a product, and it's not something you necessarily would have just made had you just been making it. You know what I mean? So, and I think the fact that other people sell something that you've created just creates a whole industry of sharks that will eat their firstborn. It's a terrible place to be.
Okay. All right. We're going to another caller. 2997, you're on the air. Hi.
2997, we are go for launch.
Hi. So I have a ridiculous question for you.
Okay, well, it better not get in the way of the strawberry because I'm eating it anyway.
Well, it can't because I'm allergic to strawberry, so don't put it too close to the phone because I may die.
All right, go ahead.
I may die, so don't put it too close to the phone.
All right, no, it's all good.
If you were ever approached by a bear or, like, getting attacked by a bear, what would you do?
You know exactly what I do, don't you? Come to me with that bullshit.
Yes.
You can't trick me, okay? I invented that.
Well, so then what am I supposed to do? Ask another question?
I guess so,
sure,
because you're baiting me. You're baiting me, and I don't respond to. You know what? That is terrorism, ma'am.
I'm not a terrorist. I'm actually driving the car, so I can't be a terrorist. Like, I only have one hand on the wheel.
Well, that's just not safe.
I'm obeying the rules of the road, though. Don't worry. I'm paying attention. Slightly.
That's not a question.
Can you count higher than four?
Unlikely. There's only four members of my band, and I've never needed any numbers after that.
because in your songs you always count to like three or four, so I didn't know if you're trying to teach us something or.
You know what? I just ran out of, you know, there's only so many numbers, right?
Yep. I think four is as high as it goes.
As well, according to me, it sure is how it is.
Oh, my God. Okay. Thank
you're
you so
the best
much.
Caller. So far, you're the best caller we've had, so.
That's good. I like weird questions, and I love his weird answers, so, like, strange answers make my day.
All right, thanks for calling.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay.
What is...
No, not that one. I've already asked that one. When will you be releasing another music video, and what song will it be for?
It will be for Fallout. And we're shooting it once we're done this tour. So it will be out. I don't know when it'll be out. I know we're shooting it in December. So whatever that means in terms of how long it takes to finish it.
Okay. All right. We have another Twitter question from Mrs. Ramsey 143. If you could own any animal in the entire world, what would it be?
Pterodactyl, no question. Or a half man, half horse, whatever those things, centaur.
Both are
but
forms
like
of transportation.
Excuse me?
So both are forms of transportation.
Yeah, and I feel like the pterodactyl, like, you know, you've got the whole, you got the whole, like, as a bird flies kind of flight plan, you know, you can get places faster, you know, but then again, the half man, half horse thing is, you know, probably cooler to, like, get in if you're standing in line for a club or something. They're probably going to let in the horse guy before they're going to let in the dude with the pterodactyl.
All right. Another Twitter question from M. Trench Lover. What is the most awkward situation you have ever been in?
Okay. One time I hit a guy with my car and I just kept going.
What?
Oops.
I didn't do that.
Right.
But I don't know. What, I mean, that's an awkward question to even answer. I mean, what I don't know. You know, every day something uncomfortable happens to me. I don't know.
Okay, we're gonna go to a caller. 1247, you're on the air.
Hello.
It's you.
Oh my God. Okay. We saw you last night, by the way. You were great. And
thanks.
I yelled to you when you were walking, but you didn't answer. Anyway. So, since we assume you have personal experience, is Matt Webb a bad girl?
Yes? No? Yeah, sure.
Oh. That was, anyway, do we have any other questions? Oh, can you sing the Badger song for us? God.
Well, I would, but I forgot the words. I forgot the word. You know, I can't remember the lyrics.
Can we sing it for you?
Oh, God.
Yeah, go. I'm totally listening.
Come to that guy, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Badger, 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 mushroom, mushroom.
Okay. It was good. It was really good.
Thanks. Maybe we can be famous someday like you.
Yeah, I mean, it was, you give me way more. I'm not even really,
Okay. Thank you for calling. Okay. Okay. Amanda, you're going to have to go.
All right. Okay. Another Twitter question from Savannah Ramsey. She wants to have a shout out and wants to know how much Coke Zero you drink in one day.
A lot. quite a bit. I don't know. I don't, like, keep track of it. I don't, like, you know, keep a tally going or anything. So far, I haven't had any today. But to be fair, I woke up 5 minutes before I called you guys, or 10 or so. But, you know, there'll be a lot of that will happen today.
Okay. And I want to know, if you could trade places with anyone in the band, who would it be and why?
I'd probably, does it have to be in my band, though?
It could be in your band or anyone else's band.
Well, if it's someone else's band, I'd have to take, like, Bono, you know? That guy's probably doing okay for himself. You know, U2's had a pretty good career. Most people know at least a couple of songs. I'd probably take that guy. Plus, I'd love to just have like a wicked Irish accent just all day. That would be the best part about being Bono. Who cares about the billions of dollars the guy has? Seriously, the best part about being Bono would just be chatting in that wicked Irish accent. You know, it'd be so good.
Yeah.
Just, like,
don't tell me you wouldn't love to just be Irish just for like a day. Hey, it's Chelsea Martin. Like, that'd be so sweet.
Yeah.
Well, you faking accents reminded me of November 24th.
Mm.
That's so frozen, my favorite video. Anyway. When do you plan on going into the studio to record another album?
Come on. This one hasn't even been up for a week. Give me some goddamn time. I don't know. When I'm sick of this one.
That was a good answer. That was my favorite ever of that question. Okay. I'm going to go to a caller now. (laughs) 7313, you're on the air.
Hi, Josh.
Hey, how's it going?
Hi, my name's Abby. If it's okay, I have, like, two questions.
It's totally over the line, but go ahead. I'm kidding. Yeah, fine.
Okay. Well, first of all, did you, Matt, Mike and Ian all grew up in the same town together when you were younger?
Well, we grew up in the same city, but we didn't like, you know, play together as kids or something, if that's what you're asking.
Oh, okay. And my second question is, have you ever heard of the Bacon Hawk?
No, but something tells me I'm about to.
Yeah, it's a majestic animal. Just wondering if you knew about it.
It's weird because most majestic creatures in the animal kingdom don't escape my knowledge. However, this one will remain aloof.
All right. Well, thank you, Josh.
Hey, I'm here for you. I'm here for you.
All right. I'll remember that.
Okay, good. Right. Be sure that you do.
Okay, bye.
Thank you for calling. Any more Twitter questions?
Yes, we have a whole lot of Twitter questions. Okay. So, all right, here's a good one. Jamaican Ramsey wants to know, what would you do if a midget asked you for a piggyback ride?
Hold on, who's giving the piggyback ride and who's taking it? Because, I mean, is the midget giving me a piggyback ride? Because that's just not possible. I mean, like, I'm 6 foot two, man. The guy's not carrying shit. And that question is even, that's assuming that midgets even exist in the first place.
Sorry.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. I don't even know anymore if they exist or not. I'm not sure.
Nobody knows. That's the fucking cosmic joke of it all.
You're getting lectured by Ramsay. It's great.
All right. Let's go with another.
What is your favorite song on Ever After?
I don't know. I don't know. Honestly, like, since we finished it, I haven't listened to it really again. I needed a break from it after that. At the time, I would say I usually like the it's kind of like the ones that sound like sing, like, it, how can I say this? It's, I like the artsier ones better, usually, on a record. Those are the ones I have more fun doing.
I think my favorite is obvious by now.
Your what?
I think my favorite is obvious by now.
It's not, but let's just, that's cool.
Really?
Yeah, let's pretend.
I've only said it like 3 times now. Okay.
All right. Describe your bandmates one word.
What?
Describe your bandmates one word.
Individually, or one word that would somehow magically encapsulate all 3 of them.
One word.
Individually,
that would
because that'll be funny.
Yeah.
So we're talking adjectives here, right? Okay.
Pronouns.
Okay. Well, Ian, I'm gonna go. Well, you can't describe someone with anything really other than an adjective if we're gonna be specific about it. Unless I did this and said that Ian is Jar Jar Binks. Not an adjective, but still accurate. Think about it. He's a lot like Jar Jar Binks. It's terrifying. Mike, a good word for Mike would be, Cuba Gooding Jr. You know, what once was promising has just turned into snow dogs. And, you know, Matt, you know, he's a bad girl.
Oh my god, I'm sorry, I just lost it because I caught it on. Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm super distracted because there is a weird dude by me on one of those Segway things, and it's really distracting because how can anyone drive around in one of those with such a proud look on their face?
Those things that they exist. I thought they were just
unless it's the guy from Arrested Development, it's not sweet.
Okay, we're gonna go to a caller.
Yeah, we'll totally go to a caller.
Hello?
It's you.
Hello? Oh my god, okay, I can't believe I'm talking. This is Katie.
Hey.
I would like to know which song off of the new album means the most to you.
Which song means the most to me? I don't know. I was pretty happy with the opener and the closer of the records. I thought those were cool.
Yeah. And which song that you have ever written means the most to you?
I don't know. It's really hard for me to answer that kind of a question because whereas everyone else sees them as like songs, Like I say it was like diary entries or something, so it's kind of weird for me to like be like, that's my the best time I wrote in my diary. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And from your first album to your second and to your newest album, the styles have changed a lot. Do you notice that? Like, do you like that?
Am I assuming that you don't?
No, I like it, but I just want to know, are you ever going to go back to the style of your first album?
You mean the one that nobody bought?
I bought it.
Yeah,
I
but
it.
I mean, like if we look at it historically, like that's the least successful thing I've ever done.
Right.
Right.
Right. So you don't think that you would go back?
I don't think I'll ever make the same album twice. I'm not interested in making the same album twice because I already did it once.
Right. All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks for calling. All right. What has been the best moment for you so far on this tour?
What's been the best what?
Moment for you so far on this tour.
The best moment so far on this tour. You know what? Honestly, I would say there was such a big difference to the first half of the tour to the second half of the tour because the album had come out. Like we took like a week off in the middle of the tour and then came back out and it was all of a sudden the record was out and it was such a big difference, you know, like all the first show that we played once the album was actually out was Chicago. We played Chicago the day the album came out and it was just such a big change from like a few people knew our stuff to all of a sudden like I felt like a lot of people knew our stuff and it was just it was weird. It was like an overwhelming feeling to me where I was like, oh my God, like a whole bunch of people, like everybody at this show seems to know our songs. Like I didn't even think anybody in this country knew who we were. And that was a pretty crazy feeling.
Well, your Canadian fans are really helpful because that's how I found out about you.
Dude, our Canadian fans are awesome.
All right. And I have a Twitter question from @Shayle. What's one song you wish you would have written?
God only knows, but the Beach Boys.
Okay.
Amanda, your turn.
Yep. Okay. So, what is the best and worst part about touring?
The best part about touring is getting to actually, you know, that's the most sort of visceral way that you can actually connect with the people that like our stuff, sort of the way that you really feel the most, the way that I feel the most, like, humbled and just sort of gratitude for seeing people like us and just enjoying what we do and it always just makes me feel really lucky and fortunate. And the worst part about being on tour is not being home. You're never home.
That's gotta be one bad thing. Not home. That you're hiding home. I have a Twitter question from MT Cowgirl JD. They want to know, how did you name your cat?
I'm sorry, you're going to have to say that again.
Twitter question from MT Cowgirl JD. How did you name your cats?
How did I name my cats?
Yeah, how did you name your cats?
I don't know. The same way anybody names a cat. I don't know. You know, cat, but... You know, it scrambles around and scampers around, and then, you know, a name sort of just presents itself.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go to the caller. 4297, you're on the air.
Hello?
It's you.
Hello?
It's me? Are you? Oh, my God, this is...
It's you.
Well, I'm sitting in the car right now with my mother.
Hi, Josh.
Hey.
Oh, my God. So our question for Josh would be, why Mr. Pickles? Dr. Pickles.
I'm going to answer your question with another question. Why the fuck not Mr. Pickles? And it's doctor. It's doctor to you. So it's Dr. Pickles.
Okay. Well, I'll be super excited when you're here in February in Calgary.
Me too. Calgary's always a fun show.
And then hopefully you'll be back for the Stampede again.
Let's hope so.
That comes every year, and I'm super excited.
We love you guys, Josh. Say hi to the boys.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you for calling. And my last question is, how have the American fans been towards you?
You know what? Really great. Really great. It's like I said, I'm still feeling a little bit overwhelmed at the reception that we've been getting because it has so vastly exceeded my expectations. But yeah, it's been awesome.
All right. We have more Twitter questions. This one is from LexiT09. Is there a fight that you had between the band amongst yourselves that now you laugh about?
We don't really fight. The guys in the band, everyone's pretty much worked out any differences that we were ever going to have. So I wouldn't really say we really fight about anything.
All right. I'm going to go to another caller. 2018, you're on here.
Nope.
Oh my God, is the caller a barking dog?
I believe so.
I don't see that.
Barking dog.
Hello?
What are your questions?
Hello?
Hello?
It's you.
Hello?
Oh, I'm sorry about that. I have two questions.
You can only ask one.
Oh, okay. What is the meaning behind your guys' album cover, Forever After?
The meaning?
Yeah. Like, why is it a whole bunch of toys on a shelf?
Did you read the story?
No, I couldn't.
That will answer that question for you. There's a whole bunch of stuff to do with toys on the record.
Okay. All right. Thank you for coming. I love your guys' song, Feeling Small.
Thank you.
Thanks for calling. Amanda?
Okay. All right. Gotta Be MC from Twitter wants to know, is there something on your bucket list that you haven't crossed off yet?
Yeah, I'm sure there is. I mean, I've never taken down a polar bear in hand-to-hand combat. You know, I've never had that awesome moment when I get to run into a newspaper office and get to yell stop the presses because I have some breaking news.
Yeah. Okay. Another Twitter
question. But I
mean,
those things are on anyone's bucket list, really.
Yeah. All right. Another Twitter question from Sophie. What song are you most proud of?
I think we got that question from someone else. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't really have an answer for that one.
Okay. All right. Another caller. 6020, you're on the air.
Hi, Josh.
Hey.
My question is, out of all the guitars you own, what's your favorite?
Oh, man, that's like trying to pick a favorite child. I don't know. I don't know. They're all pretty cool. You know what I would say? I don't have one that I don't like. How about that?
Anyone that
plays guitar, it's usually like whatever their newest guitar is, like whatever the one they've got the most recently is like their baby. But I don't know, man. They're all pretty rad.
Which song on Ever After took the most work?
You know, that opening song took quite a bit. That was a big undertaking doing that one, and the closer took a lot of work. And then there's another song towards the end of the record called So Soon that I probably recorded the whole song 5 times before I got a version that I was happy with. Originally it had drums and guitars and everything in it, and it was like sort of this big whatever ballad, and it just didn't feel right. So then I re-recorded it again, still didn't feel right. Then we re-recorded it a third time in a different key, and I still didn't like it. And then all of a sudden, last minute, I was like, fuck it, let's take out everything and just do it with piano and vocal. So the eventual version that ended up on the album, I guess, didn't take a lot of work because we just did piano and I wrote some string parts while we had the string players in to do on a different song, and just had like I just kind of like wrote some string parts on the fly and got them to do it, and then I did that vocal, and that's just one take all the way through. So I guess it's not that much effort for that version, but that song definitely went through the most surgery out of anything else on the album.
Well, then I'm glad you put a lot of effort, because that's one of my favorite songs.
Oh, thank you.
All right. Thank you for calling. We're going to go to another caller. 0741, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hello. Hello?
Yes. Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
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 I think it's probably the part where you ask questions now.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
What's the weirdest question you've ever been asked?
The weirdest question I've ever been asked?
Yes.
One time there was a crazy girl who came to a couple of shows that we played in Canada. She was in Montreal and in Quebec City, and she thought that I knew the secret entrance to some sort of mythical Narnia-like place, and that I knew the way to kill some sort of dragon. And she was, in all seriousness, asking me where the entrance to the kingdom was, and wrote me like 5 or 6 giant letters asking about it. And she kept showing up to shows asking me if I knew the way to, like, I can't remember what the dragon's name was now, but she kept asking me if I was the wolf and weird stuff like that. So I guess it was a series of questions, but it was pretty weird.
Insane.
All right. Thank you for calling.
You're welcome.
All right. Okay. Ash MC Ninja on Twitter wants to know, what would be the most ridiculous thing you have ever eaten?
Like for money?
For money. Not for money.
I don't know. I'm pretty adventurous when I eat. I like to try weird stuff. Oh, I fucking hate seafood, man. I just can't do it. Anything that comes from the water, is just, I can't handle it. But I keep trying it, and I hate it every time. I don't know. I've eaten ostrich. I've eaten crocodile. One time this guy in New Zealand, I was in New Zealand, and this guy gave me some weird street meat, and I still don't know what it was.
That would be weird.
And we're going to go to another caller. 5641, you're on the air.
Hey, this is Jess.
Yes.
My question is there a celebrity or a famous person that you get mistaken for?
And is there someone that you wish you would get mistaken for?
My favorite time that I got mistaken for someone, just because it made me laugh really hard, if anyone ever recognizes me, but they don't know who I am, but they just know that I have, like, some face that they've seen before, I never tell them, because I don't want to be that dick who's like, hey, I'm from this band, hello, like, I'm not going to do that, right? It's not really my style. So if someone doesn't know what band I'm from, I generally, but they know that I'm, like, I don't know, in a band or whatever, I'll say something stupid in response. So we were on this plane, and this girl is like, hey, what band are you in? And I was like, oh, I'm actually the lead singer of Aerosmith. And then she started freaking out, and I kind of started laughing because, like, obviously I'm not Steven Tyler. And her parents were laughing because they understood. Anyway, then I went and sat down, and then we got off the plane, and I was going to grab my suitcase, and she came up to me, and she's like, oh, okay, I know who you are. Can I have a picture with you? And I was like, okay. So she takes a picture with me, and then she turns to me, and she's like, all that boy, and, like, points at me confidently. And I was like, nice. And I just let her walk away.
So do you wish you were mistaken for Steven Tyler then?
I wish I was mistaken for, I don't know, some awesome person. Some awesome, you know, ninja.
Batman.
Jackie Chan?
Yeah, I wish I was mistaken for Batman. That would be awesome. Hey, are you Batman? That would be awesome.
All right, well, thanks for answering the question. Have a good time.
Thanks.
Thank you for calling. And I have a Twitter question from @ErikaNicole. Besides your hometown, what are some of your favorite cities to play shows in?
I had a pretty awesome time in Chicago the other night. Chicago is a great city. In Canada, we always have a fun show at Calgary, especially if it's Calgary Stampede, that's a good show. Toronto is always a good show. But you know what, there's not usually bad ones. Like, it's easy to name them, to go through and just name every city you've played. There's very rarely, like, shows where you're like, oh man, this place sucks, you know what I mean? Like, you know, everywhere's got its own thing that's pretty cool, and the more you travel, the more you realize that, like, a lot of the cities are unique, but a lot of the people are really, you know, the fan, like, people that like a band are sort of a community, right? So it's sort of like meeting different people from our own little community, which is always fun.
Yeah. Where would you like to perform at?
What?
Where would you like to perform at?
Where would I like to perform at?
Yeah.
I would like to perform, I don't know, on Saturday Night Live. That would be awesome, mostly because I would just want to be in a skit.
All right, okay. We're going to go with a caller. 9188, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hey.
Hi, Josh.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, my gosh. Okay, I just want to say that I love you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, I have a very serious question for you.
You are electric.
Is Jell-O a liquid or a solid?
Yes.
Serious question.
Oh my gosh, when are you going to come to Florida?
Dude, I want to come to Florida. I know, right? But this tour just didn't get there. I was hoping that it would, but we're not the ones in charge of that kind of thing. But I want to.
Okay. You can stay in our house. Well, me and my mother, we travel to Canada and all around the country to see you. So.
Really?
Yeah, we've been to how many of your shows this year?
I don't know. Summer Rush.
We've been to, like, 3 of your shows this year in Canada, and my mom went to Austin, Texas. She was actually the girl that you saw outside. You know, you met them, you took pictures with them.
Right. That's awesome.
Okay.
That's awesome.
Right.
I really appreciate
Thank you.
It. Thank you. That's really cool.
We'll see you in February.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you
for calling.
All right. Hey, Trench SR on Twitter wants to know, what is your biggest fear?
What is my biggest fear? Every time I start to write an album, my biggest fear is that it won't be as good as the last one, or that it'll be terrible. And then I always try and look at the album like I'm never going to write another one, which is really stupid because it probably just adds more pressure. Because you think to yourself, if this is the last song I'm ever going to write, it better be a fucking good one. And then the downside of that is, like, I really struggle with, like, I hate everything I do while I'm doing it, and it's always a problem for me, and I, like, totally go into bad places about it. Other than that, I don't know. Sharks are assholes.
Yeah. But, yeah.
Not to mention fucking toddlers. I hate toddlers.
Oh, Lord.
Okay. Hey, it's mutual, man. They hate me, too.
Yeah. It's a mutual hate relationship. It's all good.
Okay.
Okay. If you
all
could
right.
have
and
any
a caller.
Superpower. Oh, we're going to call.
Yes. 1449, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hey,
hello.
Man.
Oh, my God. I have a really serious question.
That's not a question.
Oh, okay, wait. Okay, yeah. Would you rather hang out and play Nerf with Pac-Man or Cookie Monster?
You're right, that is a really serious question. Well, I guess it depends. It depends on what's on the menu, like, in terms of snacks. I mean, if there's a plate of cookies, then you wouldn't really want to do it with Cookie Monster because, you know, you would just fucking eat them all. Then again, with Pac-Man, if you ran out of snacks, he may eat you. So I don't really know. It's kind of a lose-lose, really. Although, if you're playing Nerf with Pac-Man, you could do hilarious things like paint him red and make him look like the Kool-Aid guy, which would be kind of hilarious. So I guess Pac-Man.
Okay.
All
right,
thank you for calling.
Oops. Okay.
Sorry, right. Person that I just hung up on.
Not again.
I'm going to be needing to run sound check pretty soon here, guys.
Alright, we're almost done.
Okay. Twitter question from me to them. If you could be stuck on an island with anyone for a week, who would you choose and how would you entertain yourselves?
A week on a desert island with anybody, I guess, I don't know, I suppose if it was the musician side of me, then I would pick someone, if it was like an alive or dead scenario, I would pick like a Freddie Mercury type person and we could just write a bunch of sweet songs about being stuck on an island, I guess, I don't know. Yeah, how about that?
That's a good answer.
I want pineapples on the island, too.
Oh, yeah. Pineapples. Can't have an island without pineapples.
Well, fresh pineapple is pretty fucking badass.
Yeah. All right.
All right. Okay. And thank you for spending some time with us. Would you go ahead and tell everyone what your websites are so that they can go check you out?
Oh, I don't know. I just write the songs, man.
Just Google Marianas Trench.
Yeah.
There you go.
Google it. You'll find it.
Marianas Trench. I'm sure there's a Marianas Trench dot something or other. And I know there's like a Twitter and a Facebook with similar names.
All right. And we're going to go ahead and play a song. This is called Fallout. We thank you, Josh, for spending the time with us.
An empty room, I'm empty too. Everything reminds me of you. So many things I shouldn't have missed. The more that I push you, the more you resist. It's easy to say it's for the best when you want more. You're fine. What do I do? I know you're fine, but what do I do? I'm awake and trying, but you're sleeping like a baby beside him. I'm on the ledge while you're so goddamn polite and composed. You give and the secrets you keep, and nevertheless, it's never you let. It's more that I give and the less that I get. Don't tell me to fight for you. After this long, I shouldn't have to. I know you're fine, but what do I do?
You're fine, but what do I do?